on February the 11th, 1466, Elizabeth of York entered the world during significant dynastic unrest in England amidst the conflict known as the Wars of the Roses. As the firstborn child of King Edward IV and Elizabeth Woodville, her birth represented a strategic matrimonial alliance among England's divided nobility. Her birth into the House of York placed Elizabeth at the centre of the power struggles and political machinations that characterised 15th century England. Elizabeth was surrounded by luxury and royal privilege growing up, but her life was far from secure. The Wars of the Roses consisted of several civil conflicts over the English throne, waged between two competing factions of the Royal House of Plantagenet, the House of Lancaster, associated with a red rose, and Elizabeth's own House of York, symbolised by a white rose. This conflict would shape the course of her life in profound ways. The early years of Elizabeth's life were marked by her father's successful reign and the relative stability he brought to the kingdom. However, this stability was shattered in 1470 when Edward IV was temporarily deposed and the family sought refuge in sanctuary. Elizabeth's world was one of constant uncertainty, with the throne of England changing hands multiple times during her formative years. Despite these tumultuous times, Elizabeth received an education befitting a princess, learning the arts, languages, and the subtleties of diplomacy and courtly manners. Her upbringing, marked by the contrasts of royal grandeur and political instability, prepared her for the significant role she would later play in English history as a figure of reconciliation between warring factions and as the mother to the future Tudor dynasty. The Wars of the Roses, a series of intermittent conflicts that ravaged England from 1455 to 1487, were more than just a backdrop to Elizabeth of York's early life. They were a defining force that shaped her destiny. The struggle for the English crown between the Houses of Lancaster and York thrust Elizabeth into the heart of political intrigue and dynastic battles that would dictate the course of her life and the future of England. Elizabeth's father, Edward IV, secured the throne for the House of York in 1461, marking a temporary ascendancy for the family amidst the ongoing conflict. However, the death of Edward IV in 1483 ushered in a period of unprecedented instability that directly impacted Elizabeth and her siblings. Edward's untimely demise left the throne to his young son, Edward V, and Elizabeth's uncle, Richard, Duke of Gloucester, as protector. In a stunning turn of events, Richard declared Edward IV's marriage to Elizabeth Woodville invalid, rendering Elizabeth and her siblings illegitimate and seizing the crown as Richard III. This betrayal plunged Elizabeth into a precarious position, stripping her of her status and security. His subsequent disappearance and presumed murder of her brothers, the princes in the Tower, deepened the crisis, leaving Elizabeth as a central figure in the Yorkist claim to the throne. Amidst this turmoil, the Lancastrian contender, Henry Tudor, pledged to marry Elizabeth, uniting the warring factions under one banner. This promise formed the basis of Henry's claim and galvanised support for his cause. Elizabeth's life during this period was one of uncertainty and danger. Her family sought sanctuary in Westminster Abbey, living in limbo as the political landscape outside shifted dramatically. Richard III's demise at the Battle of Bosworth Field in 1485, followed by Henry Tudor's rise to power as Henry VII, signalled the conclusion of the Wars of the Roses and heralded a fresh chapter in Elizabeth's life. Henry VII's victory brought Elizabeth out of the shadows and into the role of Queen Consort. This position would require her to navigate the complexities of English politics and court life. Her marriage to Henry VII in 1486 was not just a political alliance, but a symbolic gesture that sought to heal the divisions that had torn England apart. Through this union, Elizabeth became a bridge between the warring houses, embodying the hope for a united and peaceful England. The marriage of Elizabeth of York to Henry VII in January 1486 was more than a mere union of two individuals. It was a strategic alliance that symbolised the reconciliation of the Houses of York and Lancaster. This marriage effectively ended the Wars of the Roses, uniting the rival factions under the new Tudor banner, symbolised by the Tudor Rose, which merged the White Rose of York and the Red Rose of Lancaster. Elizabeth's role in this political masterstroke was pivotal, as she brought legitimacy to Henry VII's claim to the throne and helped secure his position as king. Elizabeth's contribution to the Tudor dynasty extended beyond her symbolic significance. As Queen Consort, she played a crucial role in stabilising the newly established dynasty through her demeanour, her diplomatic engagements, and her participation in the rituals of the court. Elizabeth's popularity among the people and her connections to the Yorkist lineage were invaluable assets to Henry VII, who was keen on consolidating his power and establishing the legitimacy of the Tudor succession. Despite the political nature of their marriage, evidence suggests that Elizabeth and Henry VII shared a relationship marked by mutual respect and affection. Elizabeth proved to be a supportive partner to Henry, complementing his cautious and often reserved nature with her grace and warmth. Their union produced 8 children, including the future Henry VIII and Margaret Tudor, who would play significant roles in English and Scottish history. Elizabeth's role in the Tudor ascendancy was not limited to her marriage and motherhood. She was actively involved in the administration of the realm, particularly in charitable works and the patronage of educational and religious institutions. Her influence in the court helped to soften the more austere aspects of Henry's reign, and her contributions to the cultural life of the court laid the groundwork for the Renaissance influences that would flourish under her son, Henry VIII. As Queen Consort, Elizabeth of York navigated the complexities of her role with a blend of dignity, compassion, and political acumen. Her life at court was governed by the elaborate rituals and responsibilities that came with her position, from public appearances to presiding over court festivities and ceremonies. Elizabeth's presence lent a sense of continuity and stability to the Tudor court, bridging the old Yorkist lineage with the new Tudor regime. Elizabeth's influence extended beyond the ceremonial. She was deeply involved in the welfare of her subjects, founding and supporting charitable institutions, and taking a personal interest in the education and religious life of the realm. Her patronage of the arts and her cultured upbringing influenced the court's cultural direction, fostering an environment where skills and learning could thrive. The Queen Consort's role in diplomacy was subtle yet significant. Elizabeth maintained correspondence with other European monarchs, subtly weaving her influence into the fabric of international relations. Her connections to the Yorkist and Tudor factions made her an invaluable mediator within the politically charged atmosphere of the Tudor court. Despite her engagement in the realm's cultural and charitable activities, Elizabeth's life was not without personal tragedy. The death of her son, Prince Arthur, in 1502 was a profound loss that deeply affected Elizabeth and Henry VII. Her death on February the 11th, 1503, her 37th birthday, shortly after giving birth to her last child, who also died, marked the end of an era. The kingdom mourned Elizabeth's passing, a testament to her popularity and the affection in which her subjects held her. Elizabeth of York's legacy is indelibly linked to the success of the Tudor dynasty. Her marriage to Henry VII marked the end of the Wars of the Roses and the beginning of a period of relative stability and prosperity in England. Her role as mother to Henry VIII and grandmother to Elizabeth I further cements her place in history as a matriarch of one of England's most influential dynasties. Elizabeth of York's role as a mother was central to her legacy, shaping the future of England through her offspring. She gave birth to several children, with 3 sons and 2 of her daughters surviving infancy, a testament to her significant contribution to the Tudor lineage. Her first son, Arthur, Prince of Wales, was groomed to be the future king, embodying the hopes and aspirations of the Tudor dynasty, However, his untimely death in 1502 deeply affected the royal family. It altered the course of English history, paving the way for his younger brother Henry to ascend to the throne as Henry VIII. The succession of Henry VIII marked a transformative period in English history, characterized by religious reforms, the establishment of the Church of England, and significant political and social changes. Elizabeth's influence on Henry and his reign may be indirect, but as his mother, her legacy is intertwined with his actions and the shaping of Tudor England. Margaret Tudor, Elizabeth's daughter, perpetuated her mother's legacy by marrying James IV of Scotland, setting the stage for the future merger of England and Scotland under their grandson, James I of England and 6th of Scotland. Elizabeth of York's legacy is not solely defined by her children's achievements, but also by her role in unifying a nation divided by decades of civil war. Her marriage to Henry VII symbolised the reconciliation of the Houses of York and Lancaster, ending the Wars of the Roses and establishing relative peace and stability in England. Through her children, Elizabeth contributed to the foundation of a dynasty that would leave an indelible mark on English history. Her death in 1503 marked the end of an era, but her legacy lived on through her descendants, who continued to shape England's destiny. Elizabeth remains a significant figure in English history, as a queen consort and a mother whose lineage would reign over England for generations. Her life and legacy embody the transition from medieval to early modern England, highlighting her pivotal role in shaping the Tudor dynasty and the nation's history.